In this video, we'll see about ABAP search help. Search help gives the option for the user for the selection of values. As we are seen on the MM03 screen, on the field, we get an icon or we can press the F4. So we get a pop-up. There, we can enter the selection criteria and based on that, we get a list of materials. So that type of option is called search help. Again, go to MM03. Here, press F4, if you get this pop-up, if you enter some short name inside this, so we get the list of material matching with the content which we are given, like I have given cement. So you can see all the materials which are displayed here are containing the cement. So search helps give option for the selection of different materials, different objects, customer, vendor, etc. You can create search help or any table. So there are two types of search help. One is the elementary and second is collective search help. In the last video of database help views, we have used the concept of elementary search help. If you use the elementary search help, we get only single tab. Like here, two tabs are there. So in case of elementary search help, we get only single tab. And by the combination of different search helps of elementary type, we can make a collective search help. So both search help will see one by one. First, we'll create the elementary search help. So we have our table employee master. On this table, we'll create a search help. You can create on table or on the database view. So go to SE11. The search help, give the name which we want to create. So I'm creating the same name, ZESH_EMP_master. Okay, it is already exist. Let's say master one, elementary search help for employee master. Give a meaningful description so it is easy to identify. In the selection method, either you can give the table name or the view name. So this time I am entering here the database table. Here enter the search help parameter. I am selecting as employee ID, first name and last name. All will be my importing parameter, and in return I want the employee ID. The L position is the position on the selection screen, and S position, this is the position once the list is coming. Let's say this time I'm selecting here dialog with value restriction. Save. I'm saving a local object and activate. So I copy this. Now go to a database table, that is ZEMP_master. The change mode, I am assigning the new search help. The old one I am deleting from here and I am attaching the new search help here. System will give the proposal, like this is the search help parameter and this parameter is matching with the table name EMP master, the employee field. Copy, activate. Now as we assign the new search help, go to content, execute, click on new record. This time we can see a selection option. Last time it was directly displaying the values because in the database I have set as display value immediately. In that case, system directly gives the list. Now as we have selected here dialog with value restriction, because of that it is giving a selection option. If you press enter, then you can see the list. The L position in the search help, like 1, 2, 3, this defines the sequence like this, the employee ID, first name and last name, and this is called the S position. And I already written the employee ID as return field. If I double click here, this will get returned. Now we'll see one more option in the elementary search help, that is called as the fuzzy search help. If you see here, you can see proposal search help for the input fields. Check the checkbox and also tick mark this checkbox, that is full text fuzzy search. Now activate. Now see what is the impact of this. Again go back to our table, go to content, execute, create. In this case, if you assign fuzzy search help, then if you type the short name, like as soon as I'm typing some name, the corresponding matching values automatically come on the screen. We can type any value. We can type either the employee ID, we can type the first name, or we can type the last name. Based on the checkbox which you selected, whether it is a full text fuzzy search or for a particular field, system will behave like this. So this is very helpful if you want to provide a search help like a input field. Just research in Google. If you type some short words, system show the matching words from the database. Similarly, you can make use of this fuzzy search in the elementary search help. So this way we can create for elementary search help. I'll create one more for our exercise. The second is my communication table. So I will select at zemp_com. That is the communication table. Go to SE11. Enter zesh_emp_communication. Create. Again, I'm creating the elementary search help. Elementary search help for communication details. This time I'm entering the second table, that is zemp_com, and here I'm selecting again the employee ID and I'm taking only one as the mobile number. Importing, exporting only employee ID. L position, S position also same. Save as a local object and activate. Click on test. Here also select dialog with value description. Activate. Execute. So you can see the option here. Press enter. You can see the list of values. Now, both the first and second we have created as the elementary search help. Now using those two elementary search help, we'll create a collective search help. As I explained, a collective search help, it is a collection of multiple search elementary search helps. So now using both first and second, we'll create the third one, that is the collective search help. Go back. This time the search help enter as Z collective search help. Select collective search help. Execute. Here enter as collective search help. Now here in the include search help, you have to add all the elementary search help which you want to add in this collection. So first one is our Z elementary search help _emp_master1. This was the first one. And second one, Z elementary search help _emp_com. So by using both two collective elementary search help, I am creating a collection. Go to definition, the search parameter which field I want. So I want in the return my employee ID. So that employee ID I'm entering here as a importing and as exporting. We also have to give the data element, the same data element which is there in the table. Save, check, and activate. Now we'll see what is the impact of collective search help. Go back to our table, that is zemp_master. Click on change mode, employee ID, search help, remove the old one. Now I'm entering the new search help, that is zcollection_search_help. System is giving the proposal. Copy. Activate. Just come back out of the screen and go again for testing. Display, content, execute, create. Press F4. See here. Now this time you can see two different tabs. One is on the first table, that is the employee master, and second is on the communication table. Okay. If you enter any value in the first, system will give the list based on the employee master table. But instead of employee master, if you know the mobile number and you want to search based on the mobile number, then you can search through the communication. Like this time, we can search with the mobile number also. So in this way, we can combine several elementary search help for making a collective search help. This is very useful, as here I shown by assigning at the table level. Most of the time, we assign the search help in the program or in the screen field. So in this way, we done with the session, that is elementary search help and a collective search help.